I'm Tom Cady, and I'm an attorney at Fargo Patent and Business Law. Today I'm going to talk about business partnerships. Business partnership is like a marriage. One attorney friend of mine once told me, you need a date before you get married. My friend was talking about business partnerships and how to pick the right partner. When a business partnership is formed, the parties are essentially tying their success together. This is a significant thing. You're likely filing taxes together, have some form of relationship, and need to make some joint decisions. This discussion doesn't just pertain to formal partnership type entities. It also includes smaller LLCs, corporations, limited partnerships, and other such variations. Large corporations and other entities may have some traits that are relevant to this discussion, but for the most part should be looked at with a slightly different perspective. When a group of people decide to partner, I strongly advise the partners have an honest, in-depth discussion to clearly ensure the goals and values are aligned. Oftentimes, a dispute within a partnership arises later down the line because the parties never fully understood their collective purpose and their individual opinions. These partnerships are financially tied together. If one partner is not performing, all the partners in the organization may be negatively impacted. One good practice when you're forming a partnership, an LLC, or such entity, is to write out and sign a description for each of the respective individual's roles and expectations. Further, compensation should be discussed at this point. People have many different methods to manage their money. When one partner believes all excess cash should be saved within the company and another party believes that the partner should pay out every penny of revenue, a conflict is likely to follow. Regardless of whether it is responsibilities or how money is spent, if the partners are not on the same page when it comes to decisions, conflicts can arise. Joint decisions need to be made in a partnership. When you form the partnership, an agreement should be put in place to determine how decisions should be made. In a partnership, it is inevitable that there are disagreements. As long as there is a reasonable method to settle the disagreement, the partnership can successfully navigate the disagreement. Disagreements in itself are not a bad thing. When a partnership is formed, a method should also be put in place to unwind the deal should there be that need. So this is important to consider because not all partnerships work out. If you don't have a reasonable way to unwind a partnership, there's a likelihood that the company will fail when it's unwound. It is a good practice to have a buy-sell agreement in place so that if a partner wishes to exit, they can have that option. Ideally, this agreement will determine what to do with assets, customer lists, and so on. All of our attorneys have experience running businesses and understand business. This unique trait can help bridge that gap between the needs of business and the needs of the legal system. Again, this is Tom Cading from Fargo Patent and Business Law.